Hi. I was asked to help to make it more radical, to explore what would be the things that we could miss out on. So I was thinking about, okay, how do we miss out on things? Because if you talk about pensions, you're talking about something that's going to happen in the far future. So you want to do a thing now that is valuable for a 30-year-old in 2059 roundabout. Radical redesign is basically about disruption. And nobody knows the future, so we don't know what's going to happen. But what we know is that as soon as it has happened, it makes sense. Before it happens, it's unimaginable. One of my favorite examples of disruption that already has happened is the internet. If you look at 1995, the internet starts, and if you have a CD shop owner, you will talk about the internet, and he will say, oh, that's nice, I can make a digital business card of my small CD shop, and that's what's going to bring. And if you look at the guys who know Technic, then they see all different kinds of ways to make the processes more efficient. We know that now is the intranet part of the internet. But when it becomes really, really different, if we start building new IT concepts, like portals, like shops, that created things we could not imagine. And for the CD shop owner, that meant that now we have Spotify giving people access to all the music of the world for the price of a quarter CD per month. And that is the kind of disruptions that will happen between the moment of now and the moment you go into pension. So what could be this blind spot that we all miss out of if we are going to look for this challenge? Well, radical redesign needs something very special. Not try to fix the old system, but create a completely new system that also works and could get rid of the old system. And my thought, having heard this challenge, is what could be the thing people of pension funds, people that think we are building a solution for pension funds, have a hard time of skipping? Is it feasible to invest in the future? Because if we talk about investment funds, we are talking pension funds, we're talking about investment. I really loved the start of Francine this morning where she said it's not a financial product, it's taking care of humans. I love the concept of FIRE where we say it has to make sense before. And actually, I want to take those concepts and make them 2, 3, 4 steps bigger. Because if you're talking about investment, we always talk about the concept of the economy of growth. And if you look up the movie on YouTube, The Story of Stuff, then you will find out that in the economy of growth, there are also a number of things going wrong. And it helps us to grow the amount of money, but it also has a lot of bad sides. So this could be room for improvement. We have a lot of entities who invest in critical infrastructure. But the challenge they have is they invest in critical infrastructure, billions and billions, and they are going to depreciate that over 20, 30, or 40 years. That means the value in their books will diminish on a linear scale, which means that the assumption behind that is the world will not change. That means that if I do an investment now that is depreciated in 2059, I think the way we solve the problems in 2059 is the same way we solve the problems today. This could be a second challenge. The third challenge we have to look at is in. Is investing in longevity. Because what happens when your pension starts and we have this great medical breakthrough and it says, well, now you can live for 20, 30 years longer. What we did with mice in 2017 is now available for the humans. So those are elements that would be so nice to put in your new solutions. Oh, that was too fast. So, economy of growth, if you look at solutions that work on a radical different way, is non-economical systems. Non-economical systems are hard to imagine for humans, but if you take, for example, a bird that builds a house, he just walks around, takes the wood, and makes it a house. If you compare that to what humans do, is we go around, we buy stuff, and then we come at home and we notice that we do not need it. What would happen if you have a chip in this stuff? And if you don't move it for a year, it becomes part of the publicly owned goods. Now, we all made stuff for one purpose only, but what if we find a Lego kind of way to build stuff? That would mean that after a year, we get a lot of Lego back to build new entities. That means that by buying the stuff for the first time and only keeping it when it's usable, all the things that are not usable get publicly owned so that everybody can build upon it. The second challenge was the investing in critical infrastructure. The way we invest in critical infrastructure is that we invest in unmovable stuff, which we depreciate for 40 years. That's a current belief. But if you look, for example, at cities, all the things that are built there, if we change it a bit, it becomes debris, it becomes garbage. But if you look, for example, at festivals, those are built on an infrastructure of almost nothing. Then we build entities where 10,000 people can live for 5 days. And then it starts moving. So can you imagine that emergent cities like festivals mature in the next 40 years in a way that we get movable cities? If you're taking those kind of concepts into your solution, you're doing things that not are only valid for pension funds, but for all critical infrastructure parties, because they have those problems. The problem of longevity is that you are now investing in systems and you don't know the moment that you will die. But what is pretty sure is that if you're having a good time, that moment can be postponed for a very long time. So if you want to build systems that function like that, I would challenge you to rethink how we build the systems today. In the world of today, we build systems that are cost efficient. If you look at nature, for example, there are systems that are extremely resilient, that are emergent, that are anti-fragile. Those are new ways to design systems. So what happens if you build systems that work? Because if you are in 2059, you want the systems to deliver services to you. It is not important that other parties make money out of it, you just want it to work. So the engineering of those systems, the crowdsourcing of those systems, should only aim at creating working systems.
If you don't have to create a lock-in, if you don't have to create how do we force people to pay, you radically change the system by making it easier to design, because you don't have two design challenges, the money making and the engineering, you only have one. And you can do it in a way that it's, if it's valuable for you, it's valuable for all the other people of the world. So basically, it's an invitation to co-create. A great thing of this hackathon is that we are working in the digital realm. That means that if you design a solution that works in one place on the earth, it automatically works everywhere. And if you talk with Rutger, then it's all about the digital infrastructure. Now imagine that taking care of the world of tomorrow, of your world of tomorrow, of the world of tomorrow, of your loved ones, could be an effort you do for all the people of the world. That means you are opening up a giant co-creation space. You are giving access for this space for all the critical infrastructure parties, all the pension funds, so you have a lot of people, of entities that would like to help you assure that goals. And you're working on such radical new concepts that it is going to be feasible of to look at the new technical concepts that are starting to exist in the AI realm, in the blockchain realm. So it's not only the traditional blockchain, it's the DAO, it's the AI DAO, it's the user-created list, it's the stake machine, it's the public utility networks. So all those new radical concepts, and during the preparation or the hackathon, you can find ways how to use those technologies in a radical new way, as was done with the internet, as we discovered portals, as we discovered connecting machines to the internet, which gave us the mobile phone. So what I want to challenge you to is to look at the FIRE concept, to look at the talk of David Bowie, and make it 10 times more crazy and beneficial for all. Because I can promise you then, it's not only APG who's going to help you, but we, for example, are going to help you as well to succeed in your mission. Thank you very much.